Hi students, in this session we will discuss about transportation in animals. Do you know how do animals and plants stay alive? Most living organisms need three basic things to stay alive and to perform various activities: food, water and air. The food we consume is digested into simple absorbable substances called as nutrients in the digestive system. All living organisms need to transport materials like food, water and oxygen to various parts of the body. Food and oxygen are transported to all the cells in the body for growth and respiration. Waste products are transported from the cells to organs that excrete them. Not all of the food we eat can be used by the body, so eventually some will exit in the body as waste. So here we are discussing about especially transportation in human beings. As you know, in animals, transportation is mainly through circulatory system. This system helps in the transport of nutrients in the glucose, amino acids and fats to different parts of the body. Every cell receives absorbed nutrients through the circulating fluid tissue called as blood. The circulatory system is made up of blood vessels that carry blood away from and towards the heart. Arteries carry blood away from the heart and veins carry blood back to the heart. The circulatory system carries oxygen, nutrients and hormones to cells and removes waste products like carbon dioxide. The circulatory system is also known as the cardiovascular system. The circulatory system comprises blood, blood vessels and the heart. In this slide, you can understand about human heart and its as you know, blood is a fluid tissue that flows in a special tissue tubes called as blood vessels. Plasma is the fluid part of the blood which contains 90% of the water. It is pale yellow in color. It carries nutrients, enzymes and waste materials in it. The heart is the central organ for pumping the blood throughout the body. Heart is made up of strong cardiac muscles. It is located in the chest cavity with its lower part pointing towards the left. Its size is that of the person's fist. It pumps blood rich in carbon dioxide to the lungs and oxygen rich blood to other parts of the body. The heart consists of four chambers, namely auricles and ventricles. The two upper chambers of the heart are known as the auricles. The two lower chambers of the heart are the ventricles. Left and right parts of the heart are separated by a muscular partition called as the septum. Heart has a number of walls which allow the blood to flow in one direction. These walls prevent the oxygenated blood mixing with the deoxygenated blood. Heartbeat is the combined effect of contractions and relaxations of the cardiac muscles occurring in two batches. The auricles contract first to pour the blood into two ventricles on either side. This produces a lump sound. Later, two ventricles contract to send the blood into arteries, moving towards the body, and pulmonary artery moving towards the lungs, producing a dub sound. The rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the heart constitute heartbeat. Heartbeat can be felt by placing the palm on the left side of the chest. The stethoscope is a device that amplifies the sound of your heartbeat. The system which pumps the fluid tissue to transport it throughout the body is called the circulatory system. Human circulatory system comprises of heart, blood, and a network of blood vessels. The system transports oxygenated blood from lungs and the heart throughout the body via arteries. The oxygenated blood is supplied to all the organs by arteries branching out as capillaries. The deoxygenated blood is returned to veins through capillaries. These veins carry deoxygenated blood to the heart and the lungs. In this picture, you can understand how deoxygenated blood from all parts of the body is come to heart, that is shown as in blue color. The heart is now pumping the same deoxy blood towards the lungs as well as oxygenated blood from the lungs is carried into heart from pulmonary vein. Likewise, deoxygenated and oxygenated blood are transporting in the body by releasing and receiving carbon dioxide as well as oxygen. So likewise, you can understand about the heart, which is of size of two adult hands held together. The heart rests near the center of the chest. Thanks to consistent pumping, the heart keeps the circulatory system working at all times. Arteries carry oxygen-rich blood away from the heart and where it needs to go. Veins carry deoxygenated blood to the heart where it is directed to the lungs to receive oxygen. Blood is the transport media of nearly everything within the body. It transports hormones, nutrients, oxygen, antibodies, and other important things needed to keep the body healthy. Arteries are thick-walled blood vessels which carry oxygenated blood from the heart to different organs. Pulmonary arteries are exception because they carry deoxy blood from the heart to lungs. Likewise, veins are made up of thin-walled blood vessels which carry deoxygenated blood from different organs to the heart. Here you please understand, pulmonary veins are exceptions because they carry oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart, as well as you know, capillaries have single-celled walls. There are three different types of circulation that occur regularly in the body. First one is pulmonary circulation. This part of the cycle carries oxygen-depleted blood away from the heart to the lungs and back to the heart. Systemic circulation means it is the part of that carries
oxygenated blood away from the heart and to other parts of the body. Coronary circulation. This type of circulation provides the heart with oxygenated blood so it can function properly. You also can understand contraction of cardiac muscles is called as systole, and relaxation of cardiac muscles is also called as diastole. Now we will concentrate functions of the heart. All parts of the body require oxygen to carry out life processes. We take in oxygen by the process of respiration. But this oxygen should be carried over to all parts of the body. The oxygen in the lungs binds to hemoglobin present in the blood. This oxygenated blood is taken to heart. This oxygen carrying blood should be transported to all the parts of the body. To pump this blood with pressure, we need a central pumping organ called as heart. This is the reason why our heart pumps continuously. It is a central pumping organ of the circulatory system which pumps oxygenated blood, means pure blood, into the blood vessels to be carried over to different parts of the body. It receives deoxygenated blood, means impure blood, from different parts of the body and sends it to the lungs for purification. Likewise, guys, okay, you understand here how transportation in human beings takes place. Also, we can understand there are two types of circulation. First one is a single circulation, second one is a double circulation. Single circulation is the type of circulation in which blood passes through the heart only once. Through the heart, for example, it is seen in fishes. Fish is a lower vertebrate with a two-chambered heart. Fish has a two-chambered heart comprising of one atrium and one ventricle. Gills help in purifying the deoxygenated blood. This two-chambered heart exhibits single mode of circulation. Impure blood is pumped to gills for oxygenation. This oxygenated blood from gills is supplied directly to the body tissues without sending to the heart. Incomplete double circulation is observed in amphibians and reptiles, which have three-chambered heart with two atria and one ventricle. Double circulation is the type of circulation during which blood passes through heart twice. Higher vertebrates like birds and mammals exhibit double circulation. Double circulation is the type of circulation during which blood passes twice through the heart. Higher vertebrates like birds and mammals exhibit double circulation. Likewise, you also understand about blood pressure. It is the pressure exerted by the blood on the walls of the arteries. The pressure can be systolic pressure during contraction and diastolic pressure at relaxed state. Thank you.